Yeah, hi, this is Parker with Route4Me. What do we have on the line?
Hi, Parker. My name is Steven.
Hey, Steven, how's it going?
That's going well. How are you, Parker?
I'm good, I'm good. Yeah, let's jump into it. How can I help?
We currently have a couple drivers, and we're really in need of GPS tracking. We want to make sure that our drivers are signing in at locations at people's homes and checking in, and we want to make sure that they're actually doing what they're supposed to be doing, and see any be able to take a report and see kind of what's going on there with all the drivers. So it's kind of chaotic, and we're hoping that Route4Me could help us out with that.
Okay, great. So, yeah, sounds like you need, some tracking and reporting and, obviously being able to see where your drivers are and where they have been. Yeah, that's perfect. So why don't I just go ahead and share my screen and show you how to do that with Route4Me. So can you see my screen right now?
Yep, I can see your screen.
All right, great. Let me go ahead and just log in. I'm actually logged in now, I think, to the correct account here. So, yeah, this is kind of just a sample account to show you. So I'll go to the account home here. Yeah, this will show the tracking nicely. Okay. Normally, what you would do is set up your users first. So over here on the left, I call this the blue home bar on the left. You're going to set up a user. And so, for example, do you have people there in the office that are kind of tracking or trying to track or create their routes? And
We have my secretary would be acting as a dispatcher. She would
okay.
primarily have this up all the time.
Okay, so you can see here, I've got some users kind of preloaded in here. You can name them whatever you want. So, for example, this says driver two, but in parentheses, we actually have dispatcher here. So, you can modify a user, you can add a new user or a sub user at any time. So, for example, I might just call this, dispatcher, Amy, if that's her name. You can kind of use the system. It's flexible however you like. You can see that there's different user types, and you can also see that the owner user, so you'd be the owner user on that, the administrator or account owner. You can set different owners. There's also a user role and access option, so to really make sure that whoever's planning the routes can actually see all the routes, or if you're assigning a route to a driver, making sure that they don't have a global access to the address book, or if you really want them, for example, with drivers, you want to make sure that they can't see routes, too far into the future, either to confuse them or you just don't want to give them that data, so you can change the max routes that they can see in the future. You can also hide non-future routes or hide past routes, so that they can't see routes that have been done in the past. So some of the important things there. Does that make sense or
Yep,
questions around
that
that?
makes
Or
sense. Yep.
yeah, pretty simple setup and pretty easy to do. So, all right. So, I think basically what I can do is go on over to a route and show you what that looks like. You probably saw that screen a little bit earlier. I can go to my routes list over here, and I've just got one route in here just to show, kind of tracking and everything like that. So here's the actual route itself. Once you've set up users, your dispatcher can actually have access to routes even if you set them up. Or if she or he actually plans them and sets them up in the account. And all they have to do to go ahead and send this to the drivers is click assign user. So as soon as they assign user, they can just start typing in and assign the driver to that. So, does that make sense in terms of assigning a route to a user?
Yep, definitely.
Okay. So once they're assigned, you'll actually know which driver is assigned to which route. You can then go into that route at any time and start viewing the tracking information. You can see, let's go ahead and turn tracking off for now. The green route that you see on screen here is the planned route. So this is the optimized route. This is the planned route. Of course, we've got a start endpoint right here. As I hover over, everything comes to life. You can see we're going one, two, three, kind of going in a circle here. And if you want the tracking data, obviously, you want to make sure that your drivers are going in the right sequence. So you can actually turn on the tracking data. You can view users live on a map. So you can actually see, hey, there's a user live on the map. That's where they're at. If you want to see the route that is being taken, you can specify a specific date period, or you can see all time. So as soon as the route is created, it will actually start pinging away. So the green route is the planned route. The route that we're going to see here shortly come up is actually the actual traveled path. So you can see here in blue, there's an actual traveled path here. You can actually see the route that the driver took. And in this case, they went off route a little bit. Looks like they did start here, going along here along the route nicely. They went off route a little bit right here, and then they came back off route. And that
Okay.
happens
Yep.
really.
Yep. And that's great. So I could see this, or my dispatcher could see this and ask the driver, after the route is completed, why they decided to take it that way. And then maybe we can, would we be able to then tweak the route here to resemble the path that they took?
One of the things that is really handy for this is that one, it does allow you to have that conversation. At the same time, drivers are using our mobile app, so they're getting live navigation. So a lot of times what we see is that, for whatever reason, like for example, you can see here the driver, veered off of the planned route. But it really didn't veer off that far, and maybe there was traffic. So by using our mobile app, he got up-to-date traffic, and instead of going this way, which would have been better when it was planned, but maybe it was planned at 9 a.m., but
Yep.
he actually was there, at 10 a.m. or 11 a.m. or later in the day. He just went off a little bit, but he got maybe live navigation, live traffic, and actually took the faster route because he used our app. So a lot of times that's what we see. So you want to see both of these. You want to see, the green and the blue. You don't really adjust these because you don't want them to match necessarily, or that's basically how you're seeing if the drivers are on course or off course versus what was planned versus what really happened. Does that make sense?
Yeah, great. So, is there a way for them to say they've arrived at their location so we can also see that information on the map?
Yeah, so there's two ways. So if I go to map settings, I can see that my geofences are on. That's great. So if I click on the first address here, the driver with our mobile app will be able to actually check in. So you can see there's, as I click on this, all of these information comes out, including the tracking information. So I've got address visit details right here. The driver will be able to manually mark, so he can actually mark an address as visited and departed. And it can actually, as you see if I zoom in here, as soon as the driver enters this particular location or this geofence, there's a little bubble around here, it will detect that that phone or the driver is essentially in that location, and will detect when they visit and detect when they depart and assign a geolocated timestamp to all of these. Does that make sense?
Yep.
And as you hover over them, obviously there's nothing in here. As you hover over them, it will show you on the map exactly where they are. So the map will actually move to where that is.
Great. Yeah, that would be really helpful.
Yeah, it's pretty helpful knowing where they are and what they're doing. So, so that's geofences. Let's see what else. You can also, if you want, it might be helpful, to actually open up, for example, there's different layers you can put on the map. So you can say, hey, I want to see current traffic, and it's going to display traffic. You can see it's a little bit green here. If we turn on just the straight driving lines, we can see that there's not too much traffic here. It's nice and green here, though. So maybe it actually made a lot of sense to actually go along this way, especially if you see the current driver. So a lot of different things you can overlay on the map. So does that make sense?
Yep, that definitely makes sense. Now, it's really important for our company that we can track data and view reports to make sure that the drivers are doing what they are doing so we can optimize how much we're spending on our drivers. Can you show me some reports or how you guys do reporting?
Yeah, there's a couple of ways to get reporting. So one is to use the activity feed. Now, the activity feed shows up in the routes route in your route editor as well. So this is where the actual route is displayed. Of course, you can unselect that and unshow it. One nice little feature while I have you is just to kind of show you this is that you could actually, just click this little button right here and shoot a text off to your drivers or a notification. It's not really a text, it's sort of like an in-app notification. So if I said, hey, please make sure to see me at the end of your shift. whatever it is. Or maybe there's a notification, hey, the gate code has changed, customer just called for your next stop. Boom, shoot it off right away, and your driver's going to get an in-app notification. As well as you're going to see all of the other activities that they've done. So, for example, if I head over to the, you can see it here, but as soon as there's a check-in, as soon as the address, there's a geofence check-in. If a driver adds a note, now they can add a note from our mobile app, either a text note, they can actually even dictate a voice note, they can take a picture or even a video, and as soon as that shows up, that's all going to show up here as well, and it will show up in the activity feed. So you can also see and drill down a little bit more. If I go to the actual activity feed, you're going to have all of this information that's there. You can search it. You can filter it by member. You can also filter by type, by date. If you click on one of these, you'll see that it was taken to that location. So you can see all of the information very quickly at a glance. Of course, if you ever need to get any of the information out, you can go to your routes. Let's just go to our routes list, and you can export that information as well. So all that data is captured. You can leave routes in here, you know, basically forever. And you can export tracking history to a CSV, or that's a spreadsheet file like that would be open in Excel, for example. Or you can export all of the data as well. So, so that's kind of how to get all of it out if you need any of that anything. Does that make sense in terms of getting the data out?
Yep, that definitely makes sense on getting it out. Are you able to look at a specific driver's driver data for a specific route?
Yeah, so since we've actually assigned a user, you'll actually see that information. Of course, if you want to go to your users, you can go to users. Let's see here. So for example, driver 4. Let's go ahead and view their routes. And again, if they have any routes that are assigned to them, they'll show up here. This driver doesn't have any assigned routes, so obviously nothing comes up. But if you want to go, basically you're going to know that this was the assigned user. So as soon as you export that information, for example, you're going to have that. Does that make sense?
Yep, that makes sense. So this route right here, how would I see the full report?
The full report. So really, you can export it if you want. You can export to a CSV.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I want to see the report on Route4Me.
Oh, okay. So one of the things you can do is actually just go to the dashboard. If you want to see the dashboard, you can actually see. Let's select a time period and say, okay, I want to see today. Anything like that, and you can then basically take it from there. So this is more of a dashboard, whereas the activity feed, which you might want to do for a specific driver, you say, hey, I want to see the activity feed, and filter by the driver. So you can actually just start typing, hey, I want to see what's going on with driver 1 or driver 2, whatever it is. And you can see all that information, and then click download CSV. And again, you can filter by date. So if you say, hey, I want to see what happened today, anything like that. Does that help?
Yeah, that all sounds great. I think that will really help with our dispatcher to kind of lock down on our routes. We're going to be really looking through 5 different routes and making sure that we're using the proper amount of drivers. And it's really important that we can track them and track the data and figure out if they can be doing something different that will make the customer more happy, or just, you know, having better contact with their drivers is a plus as well. So I definitely think Route4Me would be a good fit for our business.
Well, great. Yeah, if you have any questions at all, we'd be happy to help answer them. So is there anything else I can help with, or have you started a free trial yet?
I have not. I would like to get started, though.
Great. So if you just go to route4me.com, let's see if I can go over here. Yeah, if you go ahead, just go to route4me.com and click the big green button that says Begin My 7-Day Trial Now. No credit card required, and please reach out to us if you have any questions. Reach out to support. We're always here for you. So,
great. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome, Stephen. Have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.